Aloha and mahalo for joining me. I'm Janin, and today I want to tell you to choose yourself. Decide right now to choose yourself. Each time I make a video, I like to talk about things that really are important to women. And we as women, we have a lot of things on our mind and on our plate and things that go on in our life. So I really want to be able to help you to think about things that are important, like when I teach women how to dress, or how to feel about yourself, how to think about yourself, how to look good with what they wear. But what's most important is that I want to share with you about how you think about yourself. I think that's one of the things that we really push to the back burner. We really don't think about ourselves very much in a way that's most effective. And because of that reason, I want to talk to you today about choosing yourself. You have to decide right now that you are important. We have a lot of things going on in our minds and in our hearts, and sometimes they're not always the best. And because we're women, and a lot of us are mothers and wives, we tend to put ourselves last, which really doesn't work out too well. And it's usually a crisis that has to happen before we really realize that, something needs to change. And I want to share with you today that before you get to that point where a crisis happens or some health issue comes up, I want to tell you to decide right now to choose yourself. And do it today because you are valuable. I'm here to tell you that you have worth and value. And you need to choose yourself. It's okay if you need permission to choose yourself. I give you permission right now because you do have worth and value because we were created by God. And just for that reason is the reason we have value and worth. Without any question, without any doubt, you need to know for yourself that you have value and worth. And sometimes we're not taught these things as we're growing up, and our parents always do the best that they know how and that the best that they can raising us. But it's not possible for our parents to teach us every single thing that we need to know. That's why we have life experiences and we go through things so that we can get that understanding and learn all these valuable things. But what happens is, next thing you know, you're an adult. And then, you're busy, you have to get a job, and if you get married, you have a spouse you need to take care of or, take into consideration, and then you might have kids, and then once you have kids, all of a sudden there's no time for you, right? Because we haven't been taught that we need to take care of ourselves and put ourselves first in order for us to be healthy, to have the energy and health we need to take care of those that we love, whether it's a spouse or children, and spouse and children. If you haven't been taught this, I want to teach it to you right now, that you need to always put yourself first. And some people think that that's selfish, but I'm here to tell you it's not. There's no way that it can be selfish that you put yourself first, because if you don't take care of yourself, then there's no way that you can take care of anyone else. You have to eat healthy, which sometimes it's really difficult because I struggle with that at times too. Like, I like sugar, and sugar is really not good for you. And I know the difference. Like, when I do eat sugar, I feel really lethargic and I don't feel good after. So, I really have to pay attention to what I'm eating and why I'm wanting to eat sugar. But the other thing is, we have to do some sort of movement and exercise. Now, I for one don't enjoy working out. I don't like a good sweat. I don't know why. I'm just one of those that I'd rather sit and be creative and do something different, than go out and sweat. But I do go walking 3 days a week. Well, I try anyway, but I have a friend that I go walking with. And if it wasn't for my friend that I go walking with, I probably wouldn't go because, sometimes I'm tired. You get up in the morning, and that's the last thing on a lot of people's mind, right? Is to exercise. But because I have someone waiting for me, I know that I have to be there and show up and exercise because there's someone waiting. So it's always good to have an accountability partner, which I know for a lot of people, it's not possible. But if it is possible for you to get an accountability partner, do it, because that'll give you a reason to get up and go and work out. Now, I don't do anything hard or strenuous. I just go walking. I don't do a lot of cardios like I probably should, but at least walking is better than nothing, right? That's what they say. So do some sort of exercise. You know, if you can't go walking, you know, maybe you live outside where it's snowing or something like that. You know, do something in the house. It is possible. There's so many things that we need to do to take care of ourselves. And sometimes it can feel like overwhelming or daunting, or, you know, you just figure, oh, forget it. It's just too much work. But I'm here to tell you it is worth it. Please decide now to choose yourself. I really want to tell you that it's worth it and you're worth it. And, you know, it's hard at first, but once you get into a rhythm, then it becomes a lot easier, just like habits, right? Bad ones too, and good ones. Once you get into that habit of doing it regularly, then it becomes easy. But nothing is easy at first, right? Until you actually get into that groove. But please decide today to choose yourself, because you don't want to get old and then look back and realize, oh yeah, you know, I wish I did this, I wish I did that. You know, we don't want to end our life with regrets. That's why you have to choose yourself, so that you have the strength and energy and health to live a full life. And also, like I was saying, you know, to be able to take care of the ones that you love in your family. And now that I'm getting older, I really realize that I really wish I would have done more. You know, I'm one of those that I look back on my life and wish that I did more and I took care of myself a lot better, you know, because now I feel like it's such a struggle, because there were times where, you know, I didn't exercise and I ate bad, you know, ate things that were really unhealthy, and then you feel yucky after. I like to use that word, yucky. And it catches up with you for some reason, right? All the habits that we have always tend to catch up with us, and it affects us one way or another, right? But you need to really pay attention to what you're thinking, because everything starts with a thought. The first thing that you think about in the morning, write it down, because you have to pay attention to what's going on in your thoughts, because that just creates everything in your life, right? Your thought. It creates what you have, what you don't have. It creates how you feel. It creates all the things that you do. So pay attention to your thoughts. They're super important. You know, I remember when I was in my early 20s, I made that decision that I was going to take care of myself, because I had a family member who, of course, she was older, but, you know, eventually she had a stroke and she was really sickly and she was on a lot of medication. And then, you know, as she got older, it got worse, to the point where someone had to take care of her 24/7. And I knew that I didn't want to end up like that. I didn't want to be bedridden and, you know, having someone to look after me 24/7. You know, that's no way to live. And I love this person who ended up like that. And, you know, she's no longer here, but I just really realized that I'm going to do whatever it takes to take care of myself, so that I'm not a burden to other people, as well as realizing that's no way to live. And so, you know, it's been a struggle. There have been times where I didn't take care of myself, but I made sure that I got back on track and started doing what I needed to do. And you know, this is life, right? This is real life. Nothing is perfect. Nobody's life is perfect. So if you see someone who you think has a perfect life, I'm telling you, you better think again, because it's not. No one has a perfect life. And I know that for sure, because I've worked with so many women over the years and I've heard all kinds of stories. Even though on the outside they may look like everything is perfect and, you know, they have their life together. But after conversations with all these people who look like that, you know, it's not true. Everyone has struggles and trials, and that's what helps us grow. But as long as you remember that you're going to put yourself first to take care of yourself and choose yourself, that's what is going to keep you going. That's what's going to really make you want to live. Because you have to realize your worth. If not, then what's the point? But I'm here to tell you to decide to choose yourself right now. As you're watching this video, choose yourself. If you have to write it down, if you have to put it in your phone, if you have to, you know, think about it every day that you've decided to choose yourself, then do it. I'm telling you, do it. You have worth. And I'm so grateful that I can share all these things with you because I know your time is valuable. But I always want to share the things that I know and the things that I've learned. So please subscribe to this channel so that I can teach you what I know and what works. And please also share this video with anyone who you know would get great value. And I do have a 20-minute complimentary consultation if you'd like to work with me. You can click on the link in the show notes and let's get started. You have worth, and I am here to tell you and to give you permission to choose yourself because you have worth. And there's no better day than today, right now, to make that decision to choose yourself, and it's not too late. And I hope you have a great day. Aloha.